Imagine that one day, you're minding your own business and happily going about your day. Then suddenly, out of nowhere, you realize you can't see anything. You fumble about trying to get your bearings, but it's as if the light switch on the entire planet has suddenly been turned off. 7 billion people have been plunged into darkness, and for the next 10 seconds, all of humanity is going to learn what life is like for the millions of blind people who live amongst us. Every year here in the United States, car crashes cost us approximately $40.4 billion, and 2 million drivers suffer permanent injuries out of 6 million car crashes each year. With every single driver in the world going blind at the same time, we can expect these figures to skyrocket appropriately. With roughly 210 million drivers in the US alone, the world would see millions upon millions of car crashes in just one day. With Americans spending on average of 100 minutes a day driving, we could do some very rough guesstimating and figure that there could be about 14 million cars on the road at the time the whole world went blind. Extrapolating the results to the rest of the world, we could expect anywhere between 70 to 90 million vehicles to be driving when the lights go out around the globe. The world would see the worst series of car accidents in history, and when our vision was restored, our streets and freeways would be a mess of mangled steel. Emergency services would be completely overwhelmed, and hospitals would be unable to cope with the sheer number of victims. Most of these victims would die from their wounds, as there would simply be no way of getting medical attention to them in time. But what if you were flying instead of driving? Well, luckily for you, flying would be a rather safe method of transportation, as most planes spend the majority of their flight time in autopilot. The only time that there would be serious danger to a cruising airplane would be during takeoff and landing, although most modern planes have emergency systems that automatically kick the computer into autopilot mode and level a plane out if the pilot becomes incapacitated. Some planes can even land themselves. Though most, which sense a loss of consciousness or non-response from the pilot, would simply pull away from the landing and rise back into the air automatically. Only older airplanes would be at risk of crashing during the 10 seconds of blindness, and of those, only planes coming in for a landing. Given their extreme levels of training, though, pilots would be able to respond to audio cues alone from the mini alarms that would signal a dangerous approach and simply level off, seeking safety in the sky while they hopefully restore their vision. If you're traveling on a train when the world goes dark, then you have even less to worry about. The vast majority of transport trains are nearly fully automated, and you'd likely arrive at your destination safely, none the wiser that the driver was completely blind. The trains that would be at the greatest risk, though, would be heavy commercial cargo trains, which often still rely a lot on their drivers, especially during tricky ascents or descents. We could expect that places such as the Cajon Pass in Southern California would be the site of deadly freight rail accidents, with a notorious strong crosswind and a dangerous descent angle. The pass has already been the site of a major rail accident that destroyed several homes and spilled chemicals across a wide area. For the most part, though, you'd be safer in a train than in basically any other method of transportation, aside from air travel. For anyone undergoing a medical procedure, having their medical team lose their sight all at once might seem like a rather terrifying possibility. Yet, doctors are very well trained and disciplined, and the momentary loss of sight would likely be nothing more than a brief hiccup in an otherwise successful surgery. The medical staff would simply sit tight and wait for the incident to pass, and the only time you may be in danger is during the initial or closing phases of surgery, where vital blood vessels need to be quickly clipped or sutured in order to ensure you don't bleed out. Casualties from medical accidents would likely be extremely low, though we can't say the same for anyone involved in other more cosmetic medical procedures. Imagine, for instance, that your dentist is coming in to start drilling when suddenly his sight goes. The thought of where that drill might end up in your very sensitive mouth is enough to terrify even us. If you're having a procedure, like LASIK though, you need not worry, as the procedure is largely automated, so no need to worry about a runaway laser searing your retinas like tuna steaks. One thing that might surprise you would be the economic impact that 10 seconds of blindness would have on the world. While an exact or even a rough figure is largely impossible to estimate, we can glean some insight from the sheer amount of economic damage that 9/11 wreaked on the US economy. The impact from lost business due to the attacks is estimated at between $120 and $130 billion. And we know that in the aftermath of the attack, gold prices jumped from $215.50 an ounce to $287, as nervous investors dumped riskier investments and took to gold. With the world not knowing what was coming next after the terror attacks, investors clammed up and preferred to keep their money safe rather than continue investing and doing business as usual. In the aftermath of a global event where everyone went blind for 10 seconds, investors would immediately clam up again. Though in the uncertainty following the 10 seconds of blindness, it's impossible to guess when global economies would relax again. If the event happened once, it could very well happen again, and the effect on the economy could be dire. The lost revenue alone would likely be in the billions of dollars. 10 seconds may not seem like much time to you, but imagine 10 seconds spread out across 7 billion people. That's 10 seconds of panic, where billions of people are not working to produce goods or services, and consumers are not buying or paying for these services. Such a complete and total economic disruption would be devastating to the global economy, and the repercussions are impossible to predict, as such an event has no comparison point in history. The best we can do is look at the economic impact of previous disasters, such as 9/11, but even these are so limited in scope, affecting just a tiny percentage of the population, that they leave the impact of a global blindness event completely in the imagination. What we can safely say is that the economic impact of the world economy would be devastating. What about people, though? How would they handle the crisis? Well, given the response of individuals to previous pandemics and emergencies, we can say that the prognosis is not good. We could expect massive panic that continues for days past the initial event, and religious populations around the world would likely react in rather extreme ways, viewing the event as theological in nature. And truth be told, their reaction would be well deserved, as such a global event could have no other nature than being the act of a divine being or an alien intelligence of such an advanced nature that it might as well be a god. We would immediately see a rise in religious fundamentalism from all sides and all groups, and sadly, the global blindness event would almost certainly be the impetus for the start of a massive global religious terror movements and wars. The blindness would mean different things to different religions, but without a doubt, fundamentalists among all the major religions in the world would all see this as a call to arms. A global blindness event would be like 9/11 times 100 and make the largest terror attack in history look like a minor scuffle. Even the non-religious segment of the population, though, would almost certainly find itself in a state of increasing panic. Those seeking scientific answers to the dilemma would find none, and eventually three equally terrifying conclusions would come to light. The first would be that there exists a universal phenomenon of which we are completely unaware, and if there exists a phenomenon that can turn the entire world blind for 10 seconds, then what other unknown phenomenon exists, and what could they do to us? The realization of how ignorant we are would prompt a new panic, and we might at last see just how truly tenuous our hold on life is inside a thoroughly hostile universe. The second conclusion would be that the event was artificial in nature, which would only mean one of two things. Either the event was an act of terrestrial or an extraterrestrial intelligence. Global militaries would be on full alert, and suspicion would immediately have countries eyeing each other warily. The very idea that a potentially hostile foreign nation has the technology to cause blindness on a global scale would prompt panic amongst the rank of military leadership and politicians, though the worst danger would be in the immediate aftermath of the attack. Take, for instance, the United States and Russia, whom today find themselves in an ever-worsening relationship. Without knowledge that the event had been global in nature, either nation might perceive the blindness as an attack by the other nation, or perhaps the misfiring or malfunction of a first strike weapon. If the event occurred during a time of heightened tensions, it would be disastrous and lead to war. Imagine, for instance, if such an event had occurred during the Cuban Missile Crisis. The realization that the event could have been extraterrestrial in nature, though, would also panic populations and militaries around the world. People would suddenly feel extremely vulnerable as they realize that an overwhelmingly powerful intelligence has the capability to nullify one of the five senses on a whim. Those laughing at the response of religious people's fears of this being a theological event may want to consider the fear that they would feel believing that aliens could shut down all of humanity so easily. The final conclusion would be that this event was in fact theological in nature, and there exists no known property of physics or astronomical event in our universe which could explain a global blindness event. The sudden realization that God or a pantheon of gods is real would prompt panic amongst the global agnostic or atheistic population, and their response might in the end be worse than even that of religious fundamentalists. A deep existential crisis would likely befall the human race, and worst of all would be the attempt to discover just what divine force truly exists in our universe. Could it be the benevolent Jesus and God of Christianity, or the petty and vengeful pantheon of Greek mythology? The answer would matter greatly and spell a potentially terrifying future for humanity if suddenly we realized that our fates are in the hands of the famously vindictive and petty Greek gods, rather than the hands of the loving God of Christianity, Islam, and Judaism.